Welcome to worship on this Lord's Day. We are glad that you are with us today. Please take a moment to sign the friendship register and pass it to somebody else so they can catch your name. We invite you to coffee hour after worship today to catch up with each other. And there are joy and concern cards in the pews. If you have a joy or concern that you'd like to share, fill out that card and hold it up during the hymn after the sermon. If you're watching online, you're welcome also. We're glad to have you with us. We hope that you participate in worship. Sing the hymns. Stand up and do the liturgies. It's great. Pray the prayers with us. It'll be great. And we also want to know that you're there. So fill out that little comment box that says that you're there. Or you can use that also as for joys and concerns that you have that you'd like to share with us. As we come to worship this morning, hear the good news of the gospel. The word has come to us by power and the Holy Spirit, so that the word also goes out into the world. Let us worship God. Thank you.
Good morning. Please stand and join me in the call to worship. Grace to you and peace from God our Creator and the Lord Jesus Christ. Let the people praise God's great and awesome name. Mighty God, lover of justice, we praise your holy name. Let us give thanks to God. Increase your love for one another and give thanks to God. Let us worship God. You may be seated. Please join me in the unison prayer of confession. Awesome God, how puny is our cleverness from the magnitude of your reality. How fleeting our days measured against the far reaches of eternity. Yet we set our limited knowledge and restricted purposes against your will for us and presume to direct our own affairs and those of the whole world. O God, we are trapped in our pretensions. Turn us from our need for proof to exaggerate truth. Turn us inside out to our self-interest becomes concern for all your neglected children. Suppress us in the sinful ways we find so difficult to manage on our own, that we may joyously render to you all that is already yours. Please join me in the assurance of pardon. When we allow God to touch us, our malice is melted down, our fears are defeated, our failures are forgiven. God raises us from death into new life, from helplessness to hope, from arrogance self-seeking to humble service. Thanks be to God, and in Jesus Christ we are forgiven. Please join us in the song of joy. You may stand. Too far. Join me. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
As a sign of reconciliation, please share the peace of Christ with your brothers and sisters. Please be seated and join me in the prayer for illumination. God, source of all light, by your word you give light to the soul. Pour out upon us the spirit of wisdom and understanding that being taught by you in the Holy Spirit, our hearts and minds may be open to know the things that pertain to life and holiness. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
This morning's Psalter is Psalm 99, which we will read responsively. The Lord is King. He sits enthroned upon the cherubim.
Let the earth quake.
The Lord is great in Zion.
He is exalted over all peoples.
Let them praise your name, great and awesome name.
Holy is he.
Mighty King, lover of justice, you have established equity.
You have executed justice and righteousness in Jacob.
Extol the Lord our God, worship at his footstool.
Holy is he.
Moses and Aaron were among his priests. Samuel also was among those who called on his name.
They cried to the Lord, and he answered them.
He spoke to them in the pillar of cloud.
They kept his decrees and the statutes that he gave them.
O Lord our God, you answered them.
You were a forgiving God to them, but an avenger of their wrongdoings.
Extol the Lord our God and worship at his holy mountain.
For the Lord our God is holy.
Amen. This is the word of God. Thanks be to God. Kids of the Kingdom, gather around. Mrs. Foss has a word for you, or they're going to gather here? Okay, yep. We're welcoming the Westchester Academy kids here today, too, and some of their parents. So we're glad to have you Westchester Academy people with us today.
Good morning. So, have your parents or maybe a teacher ever said, set a good example? Or, I want you to be a good example? Or, follow the example of your brother because he's doing a good job? Or, don't follow that example, right? Have we ever heard that? So, following an example, how do we do that? Well, when we can see someone else doing it, it's very easy. So, we're going to start with a game that is a game about examples. And you can do this one sitting down. We're going to play a game of Simon Says. All right? So, Simon Says, do this. Simon says, do this. Simon says, do this. Simon says, do this. Oh, you're all very good at this. Okay, I'm going to make it a little harder because you know that I always like to make it a little harder. So, here's how we're gonna make it harder. Close your eyes. Everyone has to close their eyes. Everybody has to close their eyes. Everybody close their eyes. Everybody close their eyes. Okay, and we're gonna play Simon Says again. Ready? Keep your eyes closed. Keep your eyes closed. Simon Says, do this. Some of you are opening your eyes. Simon Says, do this. Some of you are opening your eyes. Simon Says, do this. Yeah, it's harder. You can open your eyes now. It's almost impossible, isn't it? To be an example if you can't see what's going on. Some of you are cheating, I will say, because some of you, that was not a good example. But so when I had you close your eyes, if you can't see what the example is, it's hard to follow that. And I think that being part of a church community is a little bit like that. I think that part of the reason that we come to church is to see the example, that Jesus has taught us. Now, there's not Simon standing up in the front saying, do this, do that, but Jesus is here saying, do this, do that, be kind, be loving. And I think that the Holy Spirit is here in this community, showing us the example. So when I sit in church today and I look around, here is what I see Jesus and the Holy Spirit showing us to be as an example. I see the choir over there, and some of you are singing in the choir here. And I see the example where Jesus says, praise God, love God, That's a great example. I see visitors. I see people that I don't know. And I think that's a great example where Jesus and the Holy Spirit say, be friends to everybody. Be friends and kind to strangers. Go ahead and meet people that you don't know. That's the example. I think in a little while we're going to be doing some praying. And I think that that example is here. We pray for things that make us really happy and excited, for all those blessings that God gives us. We also pray for people who are in need. That's the example that we see when we're all together in church. We hear some examples. We're going to hear some invitations. We're going to hear an invitation to help other people. And we see the example of people bringing in coats, people bringing in food, people donating money. When we see that example, we can know that that is Jesus saying, here's the example, do this. When we are here all together, our eyes are wide open, and we can see Jesus in a better way. We can hear and feel the Holy Spirit in a better way. And I think that Jesus is saying, I think that God is saying, I think the Holy Spirit is saying, love God, love your neighbor. And when we come to church, we can see the example. We can feel the example. We can hear the example. So this week, see the example. See what Jesus wants us to do this week. And start right now when you're in worship, because there's examples all over the place. Will you pray with me? Loving God, we praise you. We thank you for Jesus, who taught us the most important example, the example of love. Help us to listen to the Holy Spirit so we can be an example of Jesus. And all God's children say, amen.
Amen. Thank you for leading us in worship. That's great. This morning's New Testament lesson comes from 1 Thessalonians, the letter of Paul to 1 Thessalonians, to the Thessalonians, in chapter 1. Listen now to the word of God. Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy, to the church of the Thessalonians, in God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, grace and peace to you. We always give thanks to God for all of you and mention you in our prayers constantly, remembering before our God and Father your work of faith and labor of love and steadfast hope in our Lord Jesus Christ. For we know, brothers and sisters, beloved by God, that he has chosen you, because our message of the gospel came to you not in word only, but also in power and in the Holy Spirit and with full conviction, just as you know what kind of persons we proved to be among you for your sake. And you became imitators of us and of the Lord. For in spite of persecution, you received the word with joy, inspired by the Holy Spirit, so that you became an example to all the believers in Macedonia, Achaia. For the word of the Lord has sounded forth from you not only in Macedonia and Achaia, but in every place your faith in God has become known, so that we have no need to speak about it. For the people of those regions report about us what a kind welcome we had among you, and how you turned to God from idols to serve a living and true God, and to wait for his Son from heaven, whom he raised from the dead, Jesus, who rescues us from the wrath to come. This is the word of God. Thanks be to God. So the first thing that Paul says in his letter is we always give thanks to God for all of you. This is astounding, absolutely astounding. All of them, well, Paul was a saint. I'm not. I have, however, discovered this wonderful and slightly deceiving phrase, bless her heart, or bless his heart, which sounds even better than Thanksgiving. But it's not. Paul really did have deep affection for the Thessalonian church. This was one of his first churches. And this is his first letter that he writes. The people of Thessalonica, this group of Christians, are dear to his heart. They welcomed him. He talks about that in the first paragraph. He talks about how they imitate him. They are people who are dear to him. And in both his letters to the Thessalonians, he expresses this love for them. The Holy Spirit has acted with power, turning Paul's proclamation into the full conviction of faith. With faith, the Thessalonians turned from idols to Jesus, and the Spirit continues to act in them as they become an example to believers in Macedonia and Achaia. They were faithful, joyful, Spirit-empowered brothers and sisters, and Paul gives thanks for all of them. No wonder Paul gives thanks. The Spirit which empowered Paul's words have also empowered them, so that their works of faith, labor of love, and steadfast hope shone as an example for all. They were formed by the Spirit into a community, a fellowship of faith. But this community was not just of affection, it was of power. They were so transformed by the Holy Spirit that though they had been pagans, completely unaware of the God of Paul and of the Jews, they, by the power of the Holy Spirit and the word that Paul brought, were converted from idol worship to worship of the true God. This community, this church, formed and empowered by the Spirit, lived out faith, love, and hope in a way that was so strong that they were an example to all those around them. As the Spirit formed the church in Thessalonica, so the Spirit formed the church at Heritage. It was a different dynamic, but the same Spirit at work. We came to this place in different ways and by different processes, were converted to trust Jesus and joyfully live out our faith, love, and hope in this place. But it was the same Spirit that shaped us into this community of believers. Though few problems in the Thessalonian church were reported in the letters that Paul writes, we can imagine that there were problems because they were a bunch of people. And whenever you get a bunch of people together, there are problems. And you only need to read Paul's other letters to know that. Communities of faith must practice, therefore, forgiveness with each other and work to receive one another, even with all our faults. Along with faith, love, and hope, we have to have some level of patience with each other. This community, Heritage, formed by the Holy Spirit, is also empowered by that Spirit to proclaim the gospel with words and deeds. The Spirit has moved in us with power, has turned us away from idols that tempt us to follow or trust in something other than the Lord God. We have been blessed by the Spirit to live courageously as a witness in the world of God's love and care. I do give thanks for all of you. Yeah, all of you. That's it, yes, all of you. Even you, Bev. Yeah.
Thank you, dear.
Heritage is a wonderful community. You do have works of faith, labors of love, and steadfast hope, which is powerful. It's a powerful example to those around us. You are people of faith who are bound, who have bound yourselves to each other, as difficult as each of us may be at times. When I think of the ways that you sacrifice your time and your money for the proclamation of the gospel and the care of the children of God, I give thanks to God for you and for this community. You have embraced the values which reflect the reign of God into the world. You serve with joy and ceaseless energy. Right now, that hallway, that entrance hallway, is filled with empty tubs, which will be filled with food, which you've brought in, which the youth group has gathered, and which the deacons will distribute. The closets in the hallway, particularly this one over here, is gathering coats that you've brought in that the deacons will distribute to those in need. And on Saturday, we're going to have a hot meal for anybody who is hungry. These works of faith not only help, but they're great examples But you are not just about service to those in need. You have gathered to worship and praise the one true God and to ground your faith in scripture and learning. You make sure that that faith is passed on to your children by the example that you live before them, by bringing them here for instruction and providing for faith formation leadership. You live out your faith with welcome for all. The very structure of this building is welcoming to bring people in. The glass on the doors, ways to the sanctuary, are not designed to keep people out, but to invite them in. We have greeters at the outside doors who are ushering people in. You have received families from the Netherlands, the UK, Nigeria, and the Cameroon, China, and Venezuela. You have received so many folks from such far-flung places that back in the spring when we had our talent show, we had folks who stood up here and said, choir practice Wednesdays at 6 p.m., 6:15, be there or be square in 12 different languages. You have been steadfast in your hope as you pursue your values of welcome and care. Last week, the guiding team reported on some of its work to help make Heritage more anti-racist and inclusive. This has been hard. It requires patience with each other because racism is so strong that to challenge it challenges powerful interests in our country and maybe even in ourselves. Some of those interests tempt us to believe that pursuing anti-racism is supporting organizations whose values and purposes are not ours. This is not true. Our anti-racism work is not to support or is not tied to any organization. It seeks an ideal of equality for all persons and presses Heritage toward that ideal, even if it requires sacrifice. It focuses most on those who are most hampered by racism that infects our culture. You are making special effort to let those most affected by racism know they are welcome and will find allies here. This work expresses your hope for justice, that you do not want to be part of harming others, but want to be ones who break the bonds that hinder others from thriving. The way out of racism is long and hard. It takes work for those who think that they are unaffected to understand that racism hinders white people in America from thriving too. It hinders our souls. Racism has corrupted relationships so that it is hard for us to perceive each other as fully human, which gets in the way of building real mutual relationships. And that struggle came out last week between a couple members. They had a very intense, heated even, but honest conversation. They've since been in contact and, while deeply divided in their beliefs, retain mutual respect for each other. That's what you have to do. One of those in the discussion is a father of a teenager who overheard the heat. After they left the church, the teenager had questions, and they ended up talking for over an hour about systemic racism, social equity, and what it means to be anti-racist. The teenager now has a new awareness and appreciation of what heritage is doing to resist racism. What a great legacy to pass on to our children. This is the power of the Holy Spirit transforming lives and empowering heritage to be an example to other believers. These values and gifts are an important legacy to celebrate. Our life together as a community of faith is important to nurture and grow. COVID disrupted us from doing that for a couple years. We need to keep building that fellowship back. One family has decided that this is so important that they have paid for all of us to have a nice dinner where the food is good, the music is a treat, and the company is delightful. It's off-site, so no one has to set up, cook, or clean. It is paid for, so no one is excluded because of cost. And it's a time for the community to join each other and have fun together. I hope you come so that you can feel the affection that Paul has for the Thessalonians and God has for heritage and we have for each other. This community, empowered by the Spirit, is an example of the proclamation of the gospel, the worship of God, the service to our neighbors, and our pursuit of social justice. This is our work of faith, our labor of love, our steadfast hope, for which I give thanks for all of you. The peace of the Lord be with you. Excerpted from the Confession of 1967, which focuses on reconciliation. So using these excerpts, let us say what we believe. We believe that the reconciling work of Jesus was a supreme crisis in the life of humankind. His cross and resurrection became personal crisis and present hope when the gospel is proclaimed and believed. In this experience, the Spirit brings God's forgiveness to us, moves us to respond in faith, repentance, and obedience, and initiates the new life in Christ. We believe that the new life takes shape in community in which we know that God loves and accepts us in spite of what we are. We therefore accept ourselves and love others, knowing that no one has any ground on which to stand except God's grace. We believe that God, the Holy Spirit, fills the work of reconciliation. The Holy Spirit creates and renews the church as the community in which we are reconciled to God and to one another. The Spirit enables us to receive forgiveness as we forgive one another, and to enjoy the peace of God as we make peace among ourselves. We believe that in spite of our sin, the Holy Spirit gives us power to become representatives of Jesus Christ and to proclaim the good news of reconciliation to all. Amen. You may be seated. As we come together in our time of prayer, we remember some folks in our prayers. Abby Sherrard suffered a bicycle accident that broke her tibia, I think it was, and she's out of commission for a little while. Sandy White had a procedure this week that she's recovering from, and Adele Wasson, Mike Wasson's mother, has been in the hospital. We also received news this week that Dottie Burt passed away at 102. Also, a friend of the congregation, Janice Loudon, passed away this past week, and her memorial service is the 26th at
Seasons Retirement.
That's it, yes. The 26th at Seasons Retirement Home. Any idea on the time? Make one up. Yeah. We'll post it somewhere, yes. 26 is still a little ways away. And also the flowers up here this morning. These flowers are given by the LaCroix in memory of Sally LaCroix, Mom Alice Patterson. And these flowers are given by Noble Johnson in memory of Marilyn. And also we have the Ewing family asked for prayers for neighbor Rick, who now has a temporary pump in his heart and is in ICU on the heart transplant list. Tim LaFan asked for prayers for Tom Rudolph, a colleague of Tim's who is undergoing prostate cancer treatment. Prayers for the people of Israel and Gaza, who are all victims of terrorism and war around the world, all the victims of terrorism and war around the world. Joy is asking for prayers to forgive my sins and to give my sins. And wash away all evil. And we pray, these joys are also, oh, wait a minute. Yes, okay. And then these joys, the Ewing family is prayers of thanks for Kathy's mom, Jane Cool, has finished chemo, and the scans are clear, praying for her recovery and strength as she moves forward with long-term treatment. Sandy White, who I mentioned had a medical procedure which was successful, Polly Betts, great-granddaughter Paisley Grace Sebastian is in the NICU at Louisville, weighing 3 pounds, 3 ounces when born, is now up to 4 pounds and 7 ounces. So that's kind of a joy and a concern. And Karen Stein asked for, well, it's a joy. Her mom, Betty Stein, is safe. Okay, so it's a concern. Betty Stein's safe and effective, efficient move into her assisted living apartment on November 8th. Okay. All right. Let's come before God now in a season of prayer. Mighty and powerful God, who out of love called forth creation and breathed the spirit of life into all living things, we praise you for your righteousness and love, for your justice and grace, for the life that you give us now and into eternity. We praise you for the spirit that you have sent forth to breathe the life of your reign into us, to give us the heartbeat of faith, the courage to hope, and the power to love. Praise to the Holy God who sends forth his spirit and offers his Son Jesus so that we might be saved. Glory to you, Lord Christ, for you rescue us from ourselves and from all that threatens us. Move, O Lord, by your empowering spirit so that we might have faith, love, and steadfast hope in these days to act as your people, the community of faith, who joyfully fulfill your call to us and shine forth you in our lives as an example that others might see and be inspired by. Give us courage and energy to care for your children in need, proclaim the gospel, teach the faith, and work for social righteousness and justice. Help us to be your faithful people by the power of your Spirit in these days. We pray for your troubled world. Especially look with mercy upon the conflict in the Middle East. We are horrified by the killing of innocents and pray that combatants might choose to seek peace instead of mutual annihilation. We pray for those who are fleeing sanctuary, for those who are staying safety, for those who are fighting peace. For those whose hearts are breaking, comfort. For those who see no future, hope. We pray for those who receive the ministry of this congregation, that as they receive coats and food, they might know the love of Christ and your care for them. Help us who give to be mindful of the blessings you have given us, and to humbly offer what we can. Bless all who are providing for those in need with their gift, that their gifts might be multiplied. Lord, in mercy, look upon those in need among us. Especially we pray for healing for Abby Sherrard, Sandy White, Adele Wasson, Paisley Grace Sebastian, Tom Rudolph, the Ewing's neighbor, Rick. And we pray for Betty Stein and her move, and for joy and her sense of God's forgiveness, which is always sure for us. Comfort with your care the family and friends of Dottie Burt and Janice Loudon, who have been received into your everlasting kingdom. And we stand with Noble Johnston today and give thanks with him as he remembers Maryland, and also with Sally LaCroix as she remembers her mother, Alice Patterson. Remind we who mourn of your promises and the power of your resurrection. Send us now into the world to live as faithful witnesses caught in the power of your Spirit, through Jesus Christ, in whose name we pray. And we pray as he taught us, saying together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. If you're watching us online, I invite you to take a look on our website, hpcmason.org, to hear more about our life together. And good, the folks who are supposed to make it come right up here, stand up here, so that we can get to you right away. I don't have my list of things that we're going to see on the slide, so roll those life together slides. The Legacies Progressive Dinner and Food Donation Events, October 29th. I already mentioned that they are, the tubs are out there in the hallway. Bring in food, non-perishable food items. There's a list of the important items to bring in. Jell-O doesn't get very many points. So don't bring that in. Bring in the stuff that gets lots of points. Or you can bring in checks. Cash. That's good too, because then we can send the money directly to the folks that we're providing who are distributing the food, the food banks, and they, with their power of purchase, can get better price for things. Next. Deacon Coat Drive, Sally LaCroix.
Good morning. Kevin and Susie have both alluded to this, but we are currently in the middle of our Deacon Coat Drive. And this is something that we participate in every year as a congregation. We ask you to bring in your gently used, clean coats, hats, and scarves in order to outfit our neighbors with warmth for the winter. We partner with community organizations, and last year when Morgan Perkins reached out to several organizations, one in particular, Clutter to Care, was actually in tears because they had no coats for the folks that get services and goods from them, and they were so happy to receive coats from our church. So please bring those in. You have two more weeks. We're going to be packing them up on November the 5th. Thanks so much.
Thank you, Sally. Food with friends, Katie.
If you are looking for a local mission to be a part of or just want some fun fellowship, please join us this Saturday from 12 to 4. We are going to be serving pulled pork and pulled chicken, along with a lot of other delicious sides and desserts. This is a free meal for our community that we are providing once a month, and all are welcome, and we hope you join us. Oh, and if you want to sign up for foods or food items or to fellowship, set up, or break down, I think he sent out a sign-up genius. He did. So it was in an email earlier this month. So please sign up. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm supposed to talk about greeters. So COVID shut down our greeter program. We had greeters inside, right outside the atrium there, every week. But we couldn't do that with COVID. Well, COVID isn't over, but it's over enough. And we're going to start that again. So sign up. There's a sign-up sheet out in the atrium, or you can see Joanne McCullough, who is organizing our greeters. It's great to have people who are saying hello to you when you come in to the sanctuary area. So please do that. Is that it? Okay, one more thing. Susie is announcing a dramatic and just earth-shaking change, the journey to Bethlehem. I don't know if we can deal with it, Susie. Can we? It's being moved from December 3rd to December 10th. Yay! Yay! That'll be great. So that's just, be sure to see Susie if you can help. Okay. And then Cindy and Al.
So if you have not gotten an RSVP card to the dinner on the 12th, please raise your hand, because the ushers will give out a few more. If you got one this morning, please fill it out whether you're coming or not. because we need to know even no responses so we can take names off of lists so that Flo Wilkes and her team of lovelies who are going to call everyone doesn't call people who've already responded. So that's great. We're almost ready for video number two. Hopefully you enjoyed the one last week. If it goes by too quickly for you here, always remember that you can look at it on Facebook or YouTube, and you can just have them, and you can have a party, and you can look at it, and try to figure out, because these are all pictures from this past year, what was that event? What were we doing? We hope to see you on the 12th for dinner. I don't know if you've ever, the 5th, the 12th is Consecration Sunday, thank you. It's at 6 o'clock at the Oasis Conference Center. I'm hopeful that we can once again hear the story of how this church came to be. I wish I would have been on the golf course where it happened, because to hear the people who were on the golf course where it happened, it was, you know, quite an act of faith to have these two communities come together. But boy, what a congregation they started, and what a congregation we love. So please join us then. If you have your reservation card, give it to Al right out front there. You guys did a great job with that last week. I appreciate that. And Mr. Tim, if you're ready, we've got our song and we're going to hit it. Thank you.
Let us worship God now with our gifts and offerings.
Mm-hmm.
Heavenly Father, thank you that you can satisfy our every desire and need. Your word says that we should give honor to you with the first fruits of our wealth. Accept our tithes and offerings as a gift of worship to you. Multiply what we give for the effective growth of our kingdom. Make Christ dwell in our hearts through faith, so that we become rooted and grounded in love, may have the strength to know that the love of the Christ that surpasses knowledge may be filled with all the fullness of God through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
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 Now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling and to present you blameless before the presence of his glory with great joy, to the one and only God, our Savior, through Jesus Christ our Lord, be glory, majesty, dominion, and authority before all time, now and forever. Amen.